If you were a Disney character, who would you be? In our lives, we could all relate to at least one Disney character. For me, it would be Violet, because sometimes I wish I could be invisible.
For me, I'm most ready to Cinderella, because she's kind and reserved.
As a matter of fact, we have personally selected a character for each member of the senior team that we think fits them the best.
First, we have Mr. Kelly as Sully. Mr. Kelly? Mr. Kelly's a lovable teacher. To some, it seems scary, but he's the nicest person you will ever meet. The beer helps too. Next, we have Miss Chafee as Merida. Because she has that upbeat attitude that can take down any physical challenge that comes her way. Next, we have Mr. Sheehan as Baloo. Because no matter what, he has your back.
Now, we have Mr. Valentine as Crush. Because... because he totally has that California vibe to him, man. Now, we have Miss Alva, who's a strong, independent woman who needs no man's help. And no character is more like that than Mulan. Let's not forget Mulan's comical, yet trustworthy sidekick, Mushu. Or as we call him, Mr. Sturgeon. And finally, we cannot forget Director. No character resembles him more, no other than Mickey Mouse. Because you brought inspiration to us from the start. And you brought joy and happiness to GPA. And we thank you for that. Good morning, staff, students, Director, and class of 2017. My name is Lizbeth Gomez.
My name is Daniela Hyman.
And welcome to our senior talk.
All these characters we just show you are all different, but one thing they have in common is that they all have to overcome obstacles and come out of their own comfort zone. If you look at this picture, right about here, it's called the comfort zone. It is in this comfort zone when we don't learn, we don't grow, and we don't push ourselves. And the important question is why? Why do we stay inside our own comfort zone? The main reason we all tend to stay inside our comfort zone is fear. The fear of change. When we're not willing to put ourselves in a situation, when we don't know what the outcome may be. The fear of judgment. When we're not ready to put ourselves in front of others in fear of hearing something negative. And the fear of unknown. When we're nervous to go in front of others, when we don't know what the outcome may be.
It is these fears that permit us from breaking out of our own comfort zone and reaching to what we call the danger zone. Now, let me rephrase this by saying, the danger zone is not a place to fear. The danger zone is a place where you're meant to push your limits and maybe sometimes feel uncomfortable. But in the end of the day, it's gonna make you feel better because you overcame that fear.
When we looked what we wanted to do for a senior talk, we were looking for something that pushes out of our own comfort zone and so we could reach the danger zone. Looking around us, we noticed how a lot of people have already come out of their own comfort zone. So we noticed a few seniors who have already come out of their own comfort zone. For example, we have Sandy and Deidre, who overcome the fear of change. They were able to give their senior talk. We have Joanna, who overcame the fear of judgment and was able to be a dancer in the open house show. We even noticed Sam, who was even willing to fight to be a student in Mr. Balancing's calculus class, even though everything he will be learning will be new to him.
So we asked ourselves, how can we change? How can we overcome our fears? How can we get out of our own comfort zone? It was Director Rivera that actually gave us the idea of putting on a movie night for the school. We thought, what a great idea. We saw the opportunity that the director has given us as a way to push ourselves out of our own comfort zone and go into the danger zone.
For me, my comfort zone was sticking with my core of group of friends. I oftentimes don't express myself, especially around new people.
For me, my comfort zone was avoiding things. Whenever I was in a difficult situation, instead of facing it, I tend to run away from it. It was just an easier option for me.
What GPA Movie 9 allowed us to do was to push up, to come out of our own comfort zone that once we were self in. What we offered was to watch movies that had a positive message behind it. We specifically chose movies that have themes such as not judging others, following passions, respecting traditions, and accepting of those who are different. If you look at your life, media has a huge impact of who you are, who you become, and the beliefs you have. That is so important for us that the movies we chose were models so that younger students could learn from.
Our movies did not just provide a positive message for our younger students. It also provided a safe place for them to go after school to hang out with their friends. Southeast San Diego is no stranger to bad influence. So what our movie program did was provided a safe environment and have positive role models surrounding them.
So we thought the movie theater for students on campus would provide them the access that they can have at home, enjoy and watch the magic a movie can have. We also decided to give back to our senior class with our movie program. What movie will be complete without some snacks?
We decided it would be a good idea to sell snacks for our movies and all the proceeds going to senior talks. What we accomplished was, one, having snacks here at Gompers would let students avoid crossing the street to a paletero. Second, the proceeds that we did in our senior talks, we raised about $200 and we donated it to Selena and Diana to help with their fundraiser. When we looked around the little theater, all we saw was joy. What we learned is that nothing can make a person feel better than making others happy.
For me, I started off this project scared to work with so many young kids. However, along the way, I figured it out with the right preparation, structure, and organization. Working with kids could be so much fun and exciting. Being responsible for so many energetic and young kids helped me to come out of my shell.
For me, even though I liked the movie idea, I was a little skeptical about the whole situation. I was worried, what if nobody shows up? What if too many kids show up? How can we supervise so many kids? You know, they tend to go a little crazy at times. However, my worries quickly dissolved after our first showing. It was a shining success. The kids were happy. We raised money. Everything went as planned. Along with Daniela, I realized that a senior project is properly planned, the results can be extraordinary. Now, here's a short glimpse of our movie night.
Thank you.
we hope our senior talk has been a lesson to many of you. We wanted to come out of our own comfort zone, and even though we experienced a lot of obstacles, we came out for the better. So we hope that you underclassmen today take notes that if you truly want to grow by the end of your senior year and come out of your own comfort zone and reach for your danger zone. We hope all you leave here today with the tools necessary to overcome the fear that keeps us inside our own comfort zone.
We hope you leave with the bravery of Mulan, the curiosity of Ariel, the kindness of Snow White, and the talent of Belle. If you live the rest of your life following these characteristics, you will be sure to come out of your comfort zone and into the danger zone. Thank you for listening, and this concludes our senior talk.